In this segment, we'll talk about the posterior cerebral artery and the arteries that go to your cerebellum. Remember that the two vertebral arteries that come from the subclavian come up through some very special foramina in the cervical vertebrae. They exit those cervical vertebrae, come together at the base of the brain to form the basilar artery. And that is pictured here. So here's our basilar. And unfortunately, in this image, you would see the two vertebrals coming all kind of across like this to form the basilar on the midline. The two big branches from the basilar that I want to talk about are the superior cerebellar, and it goes around and around and comes down here and is the blood supply for part of the cerebellum, and the posterior cerebral. It kind of dives right into the brain and you lose it. You don't really get to see very much of the posterior cerebral artery because it dives into the brain. In the next image, this is the area served by that posterior cerebral artery. And we can see it here coming from, there's our basilar, and it's branching and it's coming up around and going deep. And it is going to perfuse most of your occipital lobe. So a stroke, which I've referred to in the other two segments, but one of the ways they talk about a stroke is a cerebral vascular accident, a CVA. And I always think to myself, cerebral vascular accident. Why would anybody do that on purpose? So of course it's an accident. Nobody wants to plug up one of their blood vessels to their brain on purpose. But anyway, that's the terminology. So the posterior cerebral artery feeds your occipital lobe. And so if you did have a stroke or a cerebral vascular accident in that, in the watershed area of that artery, you may actually lose vision or have deficits in your visual fields because that is the area of your brain where you see. The next thing I want to show you are just to kind of compare and contrast the overall watershed areas or perfusion areas of these arteries. So this kind of holds it all together. So this slide demonstrates the overlap and the areas served by each of the major arteries. The middle cerebral artery perfuses most of the lateral surface of the brain. The anterior cerebral artery perfuses most of the medial surface of the brain. And the posterior cerebral artery serves the occipital lobe and part of the temporal lobe. What's important to know about the perfusion areas of these arteries is knowing where the artery is and what part of the brain it serves can guide you if you're trying to understand what's going on during a potential stroke situation. If there are personality changes or if they start to act very strangely, maybe it's that anterior artery because it's serving those decision-making areas. If all of a sudden they're numb or the patient can't move, maybe it's that middle cerebral artery that feeds the pre and post central gyrus. If there are deficits in maybe their visual system, maybe it's the posterior cerebral artery that is affected. And so by knowing which area of the brain is served by what artery, you can start to understand what happens under different conditions that of ischemia or of a stroke. If a blood vessel is blocked, you can tell from the behavioral characteristics of the patient that the patient's exhibiting based on what part of the brain is being affected. In the next segment, we'll talk about the blood supply to the cerebellum.